Macy's 4th of July sale has everything you need to make a splash at the barbecue. With great deals like 50 to 60% off swimwear for all. And dry off with plush Charter Club beach towels for $40. Plus, get 40% off almost all sandals now during the Great Sandal Sale. And Macy's Star Rewards members can earn rewards even faster during Star Money Bonus Days. See Macy's.com/Star Rewards. Savings off regular sale and clearance prices. Exclusions apply.
.org. It's the Connor Happer Show with Connor Happer and Josh Ottson. Let's get ready to rumble.
Licensing of the phrase "let's get ready to rumble" just over the last 7+ years internationally is grossed approximately close to $400 million in retail sales.
Really?
You guys look like, what do they look like, Jimmy?
Dorks. They look like a couple of dorks.
On 1620, The Zone.
Welcome in. Happy Friday. Can you hear me okay? Here we are. Yeah, that's a little bit better.
Yeah.
Welcome in. Happy Friday. Connor Happer, Josh Ottson with you here on the Connor Happer Show, 1620 The Zone and 1620thezone.com. No crossover today as the morning show goes out and says farewell to Sugar Shane. Wow, 22 years for Shane. That's quite the run. That's quite the run anywhere doing anything, especially nowadays. It's definitely quite the run in radio.
The bulk of your life.
Yeah. Yeah.
Shane has been right here where I stand.
You're right. So, congratulations to Shane. And he's done a lovely, marvelous job, and he will have large shoes to fill. He will leave large shoes to fill anyway. Come next week. But we're getting ready to send you into the long weekend, 4th of July. Josh, are you a let's blow stuff up guy?
I like when other people blow stuff up.
I agree.
At appropriate times of the day.
Yep.
Had a round start at about 12:15. This morning, so
really?
Thanks for that. Neighbors.
Yeah, I've been hearing the cracks. They've been getting more and more all week. I don't want to go totally old man on this, but you never really get used to it. I mean, except for on the 4th of July when it's just constantly happening, that's fine. That's good. But then the random, like, I don't know when it's coming, pop, 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 the Monday, basically yeah. A week before the 4th of July actually is.
Happy June 27th, 7:30 p.m. Bow, 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 bow.
All right, we have plenty to get into today. We're wide open, though, here in the 10 o'clock hour, so you guys can get in touch with the show, 402-951-1620. We could still branch off into about 45 different directions off of yesterday's news. UCLA and USC joining the Big Ten. I feel very blessed. We got the immediate reaction yesterday from everybody who was like, "Whoa, this is quite the rush," and it's still there. And now we have we've had people talk about it on the record. We've had the conference itself formally announce the move. USC and UCLA. I mean, this is official. This is done. USC and UCLA will be in the Big Ten in the 2020, starting in the 2024 football season, the fall of 2024. So just two more seasons for them in the Pac-12, and we will begin on this new world of college football. But like I said yesterday, I mean, when the Oklahoma-Texas move happened last year, the immediate reaction is like, okay, what's next? And yesterday was a good mix of hold on, I don't know that anything's imminent right now. And so that was one side of the spectrum. Josh, the other side of the spectrum was everybody else that isn't in these two conferences is panicking right now, and they're begging the Big Ten and the SEC to let them in. So I'd like to think we probably sit somewhere in the middle of that.
The begging is interesting to me because...
Oh, love the begging.
I thought it would be like, hey, you know, behind closed doors, I'm hearing that some of these teams might want to be included in the deal versus... The school's basically outwardly just publicly, hey, we'll go too.
Mm-hmm.
We're packed.
Bring us.
We could be ready in 30 minutes.
Please bring us. Whatever you do. Okay, so we'll have plenty of reaction to that from the Big Ten side, from the Nebraska angle, which we didn't get to a whole lot yesterday. And then the big white whale that is out there, the one big chess piece that remains in the landscape of college football, if we're talking about brands and we're talking about brands that matter, we're talking about helmets that matter, Notre Dame. What happens to Notre Dame? Big Ten people, you don't want to talk about begging. That would be the big move. And there was Big Ten people yesterday and today publicly saying, hey, you know, I wouldn't mind it if Notre Dame came over and hung out with us. I think that'd be a fit for everybody. It'd be fun for everybody. So we'll dive into all of that on the show. Happy Bobby Bonilla Day to those who celebrate. Bobby Bonilla is 59 years old, retired from baseball after the 2001 season, and just today cleared a $1.193 million check from the New York Mets, who he only played for 4 years during in the mid-90s. And he has now done that for the 12th year in a row, and there will still be 13 more Bobby Bonilla days. But we are almost over the hill on Bobby Bonilla days.
Yeah, this is like the midpoint, essentially.
Yeah. 25 years, gaining interest, $1.1 million for his 4 years of service with the New York Mets.
Have you noticed
weird... That's a beautiful thing.
A weird... backlash
to Bobby Bonilla Day?
To Bobby Bonilla Day. I've seen a lot of tweets today like, there's so many deferred contracts in sports. Why do people care about Bobby Bonilla Day? Because it's hilarious.
It's really funny. It involves the funniest franchise that exists, the New York Mets. And it involves them. It sort of like involves Bernie Madoff. Like, you know, that entire, like, it's hilarious.
The only thing more annoying than your tweets are the tweets about Bobby Bonilla Day. Shut up. It's funny. It's hilarious.
Oh, people are over Bobby Bonilla Day?
It's lol Mets to a T.
Yeah, every year on July 1st, we get to make fun of the Mets. I don't know why anybody would want to forfeit this. Mm-hmm. I'm going to treasure every July 1st for the next 13 years.
Ken Griffey Jr. gets deferred contract from the Reds. You must be a lot of fun at parties.
The full story. He played for the Mets from 92 to 95. He was traded. The Orioles, by the way, also make annual payments to Bobby. There's your point.
Bobby's agent is amazing.
He's done a really good job. He returned to the Mets for one more year in 1999, was released at the end of that season. The team only owed him $5.9 million at the time of his release. But they decided they didn't want to pay the basically $6 million lump sum. So they decided to defer his contract until 2035 at 8% interest. Which financially, guys, that's actually more money than $6 million.
Yes. Yes, it is.
Quote, I know Bobby is happy about it, but we don't talk about it much. Bonilla's former agent Dennis Gilbert told USA Today Sports in 2018. It's just unfortunate that the Wilpons got hoodwinked in the Madoff deal. Otherwise, it would have still been a win-win for both sides. The former Mets owners, is from the New York Post, the former New York Mets owners didn't bat an eye at this offer. They were promised an annual 10% profit on their account with Bernie Madoff. That account, of course, was a sham, and the Wilpons found their money swallowed by a massive Ponzi scheme. And Bobby Bonilla just happened to be one of the benefactors of all this. Mets fans have reason to look back at the Ponzi scheme and Bonilla's contract with a smile. The reason they pushed back Bonilla's deal for 35 years was to give out contracts to Mike Hampton, Derek Bell. They pay those two in the neighborhood of $10 million are like, okay, we're not going to play out the $5 million or the $6 million to Bobby himself just to not play. Bobby Bonilla, he's talked about this recently. He's done advertising deals recently. 2021's Bobby Bonilla Day. Ryan Reynolds and Mint Mobile offered customers the Bobby Bonilla deal of wireless. The offer was 25 years of service for $100 per year. Bonilla himself starred in the series of commercials, claiming himself as a baseball genius who credited extremely long deals for being in great physical shape. It's fun! Let's have some fun! I need to be cynical about this. All right. So happy Bobby Bonilla Day to those who celebrate. It's also July 1st, which is a significant day in college athletics. It's the day the new academic year turns over. So a couple things in that regard today. Congratulations to, or happy birthday, happy anniversary, whatever you want to call it, to the University of Nebraska, who joined the Big Ten 11 years ago today, July 1, 2011. And happy one-year anniversary or birthday. I think it's birthday in this case. Happy one-year birthday, first birthday to Name, Image, and Likeness. Which...
they grow up so fast.
Man, it's changed in a year, hasn't it? It's grown up quite a bit. 1 year ago, Name, Image, and Likeness went into effect, or at least was sort of delegated out. To the individual states, and college athletes were able to cash in on their name, image, and likeness. And it was very, very cute at first, and then it quickly became sort of scary, and eventually it'll roll back around to this is normal, as most things do and most changes do in college athletics.
Well, they always say, you know, when a kid's growing up real fast, they always make the joke of, oh, next thing you know, they'll be asking for the keys. Well, a lot of these players are asking for keys in the form of NIL car dealerships. Yeah. Quinn.
Give me the keys.
That's an Aston Martin deal.
Yeah. That's your boy, Quinn.
Not my boy.
On the show today, Brian Munson, Brian Christofferson, as usual, Sipple in the 1 o'clock hour. Those are our regular guests. We'll also be joined by Adam Grossbard of the Orange County Register. I would like to get the USC angle of this. He'll join the show at noon. Here's what the main question I have for Adam, and this is something that I was sort of I thought about as this came down yesterday. The timing of this in relation to USC hiring Lincoln Riley to be their head coach. Does USC I don't know this, and we'll ask Adam if he has any knowledge or thought on it. But think about USC and where they were a year ago. And Clay Helton's their coach, and they're in the Pac-12, and it just, you know, USC is sort of a dormant, they're a dormant brand, right? They had been that way for a long time, for a while now. Hadn't been successful in a while. USC goes out and hires Lincoln Riley, who leaves Oklahoma, a national brand, to join USC in the Pac-12. And then what he wanted to do and what he saw there at first was, let's throw some resources into this. And if we can, we could be the dominant team out west, and it wouldn't even be that difficult for us. We'll kill it in recruiting. That's sort of a given no matter what if you're at USC. But if you put a little back into it, if you put a little elbow grease into it, talking about facilities, football-only facilities, things that Lincoln Riley has seen from being in Oklahoma and being, you know, opponents of Big 12 schools or SEC schools or Big 10 schools in the past. This is real big-time college football. And USC had been getting along over the last few years, without doing that. So they could have kept getting along. But they hired Lincoln Riley. And Lincoln Riley said, whoa, are we gonna keep sifting into, you know, just shifting back into nothing, into almost irrelevance in the college football world? Because we definitely don't have to if we don't want to. I would imagine that Lincoln Riley And it sounds crazy. We're talking about two major universities and how much money is on the line here, Josh. But I would imagine that Lincoln Riley was one of the spearheads in this deal.
We got to do better. This isn't what big time programs do. Yep. You guys aren't running it like a big time program.
Yep. Why did I come to USC if we're not going to act like it? And this move is something that I guarantee you, and I'm sure you, I didn't read Lincoln Riley's statement, if he had one yesterday.
Yeah. Between the two LA schools, Stanford and Oregon, there's enough money in this conference that we need to be in with the big boys.
Yep. So I imagine Lincoln Riley had a lot to do with this. So I'm curious about the sort of timeline of the whole thing. Because what? Lincoln Riley was hired in December?
That sounds right, yes.
You know, November, December, basically after Oklahoma season ends. And based on the timelines of all the stuff that I read yesterday, this has really heated up over the past 6 to 8 weeks here. I'd imagine, I'd imagine that's part of it. And part of the initial sort of findings from Lincoln Riley of, hey, this is sort of what we need to do. So we'll talk about that with Adam Grossbard of the Orange County Register in the noon hour. But the lineup today is powered by the Rooferies at John Higgins Weather Guard. The Big Ten Network will be just showing a whole bunch of drone footage of the city of Los Angeles today.
Right now. Have they shown a UCLA or USC game yet and branded it as a Big Ten game?
It'd be really funny.
Big Ten Classics.
They had
Foster Farms Bowl, UCLA, Nebraska.
They video conferenced in Urban Meyer last night.
To talk about what?
Life.
Oh. So you're a failure. This is what success looks like. This is what success looks like.
You think Urban will fall straight back into the TV analyst thing and we're just going to act like his whole thing in Jacksonville didn't happen?
Yep.
All right. We'll see how that works out for him. Also, the more I hear about the more I read about yesterday and the whereabouts and what Kevin Warren was doing is really, really funny to me.
It's hilarious.
And there was some communication, obviously, and he brought the athletic directors in and they did the formal vote, you know, last night. And basically, there was a really good rundown in the Athletic today. But basically, Kevin Warren gets his people in a group and says, you know, speak now or forever hold your peace. Nobody had an issue with it, and they roll forward with it. All this while he's across the pond in London. He's going to go meet with some people and then take in a Wimbledon match or two this week. It's really, really funny.
It's just so on brand. Like the public perception of Kevin Warren to a T yesterday.
It's pretty good. All right. Want to hear from you guys as always on the show on this Friday edition, 402-951-1620. You can tweet Connor at 1620thezone.com and the JTech Construction Zone. Nope. Whoa. You can tweet at Connor Happer at Happer Show on the JTech Construction Zone Twitter feed. You can email Connor at 1620thezone.com on the Equitable Bank inbox. It's 4th of July weekend. We will wonder out loud later on how many hot dogs Joey Chestnut will eat on Monday. You roll out of bed on Monday, and you find your way to the television, and you will find the world's greatest eater trying to break another world record. He will try and slam 75 more hot dogs and buns on very hot and steamy, gross and smelly Coney Island on Monday afternoon.
Yeah, you've got Coney Island takes too, so I'm kind of excited to get into those.
We could talk about Coney if you'd like. Old Coney. But like I said, you guys can call, text into the show. We'll come back. We'll fire things up. We'll take this conversation a couple different ways today with the news from yesterday. More up next on the Connor Happer Show on 1620 The Zone.
Macy's 4th of July sale has everything you need to make a splash at the barbecue with great deals like 50 to 60% off swimwear for all and dry off with plush Charter Club beach towels for $40. Plus, get 40% off almost all sandals now during the Great Sandal Sale. And Macy's Star Rewards members can earn rewards even faster during Star Money Bonus Days. See Macy's.com/Star Rewards. Savings off regular sale and clearance prices. Exclusions apply.